Hello everyone, welcome back to illphocorphics. In today's tutorial, I will show you how can you change a background and match the subject with the background. This is an image manipulation tutorial where I show you how easily you can match the subject with the background and create awesome image manipulation in Photoshop. This is really a very good tutorial where I show you all the methods and tricks step by step so that a beginner also can learn something new. I hope you will like this tutorial. So watch the tutorial carefully until the end, and learn how can you also create image manipulation in Photoshop. Don't forget to tell me your valuable word in the comment section below. Leave a like, and subscribe if you didn't yet. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon so that you get all the notification of new tutorials when I upload, and don't miss any new tutorials. So be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. So let's start today's tutorial. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have downloaded 3 images to show how can you change the background and create image manipulation in Photoshop. If you like to download all the images, just check the link in the description. I will put the link to download all the images. Now first, we need to remove the sky from this image. So go to the toolbar, and take quick selection tool. Now select the sky. Go closer. See if the selection is perfect or not. Adjust brush size. And unselect the area that should not be selected. Now if I go closer, then you can see, in default, it's showing plus point. That means it will add selection, but if you press Alt or Option on your keyboard it will show a minus point, that means it will remove the selection. Now take your time and make the selection perfect. Now we made the selection. Next, go to Select and Invert. It will invert the selection. Then apply a layer mask to the image. Take the Move tool. Now we remove the sky from the image, and we will add another sky to this composition. Go to the Sky Image document. I have downloaded this image for the background sky. Unlock the layer. Take the image and paste it to the main composition. Put the sky layer back to the car layer. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open the free transform. Zoom out, and make the background sky bigger. Hit OK. Next, we will increase the height of the image. Go to the toolbar, and take Crop tool. Click and increase the height of the image. Hit OK. Take the Move tool. Again press Ctrl or Command plus T to open the free transform. And make the image bigger. Press the right button on your mouse, and select Flip Horizontal. Put the image in the perfect area, and make all the adjustment. Hit OK. Now go to the toolbar, and take Crop tool. Now we are going to delete the outside area of the image. Select Cropped Pixels. Click. Then hit OK. Now take the Move tool. Next, we will add the model to our composition. Go to the Model Image document. We need to make a selection and remove the background from the model. Go to the toolbar and take Quick Selection tool. Now select the model. Take your time and select the model as perfect as you can. Now we select the model. Next, we need to refine the edges for the model to get more perfect selection. Go to Select and Mask. Now go closer. Adjust the brush size. Select the Refine Edges brush, not the other brushes. Now again take your time and refine the edges. Now we refine the edges. Select the output as a new layer with layer mask. Next, we need to make more adjustment to the selection. Take the brush tool. Zoom in, adjust the brush size. Now bring this area back. Take your time and make all the adjustment to the image. Now we are done. Take the Move tool. Take the image. And paste it to the main composition. Take the layer to the top. Delete the layer mask. Select Apply. Go closer. Put the image in the perfect area. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open the free transform. Now adjust the image and put the image in the perfect area where you like to put the image. Now that's perfect. Hit OK. Next, we will add a shadow to the bottom of the model. Create a new layer to the bottom of the model layer. Go to the toolbar, and take brush tool. Change the foreground color into black. Now paint the black where you like to add shadow. Now change the blending mode into soft light. Next, we need to adjust the shadow. Apply a layer mask, and adjust the shadow. It's okay. Take the mood tool. Now you can see how we add shadow to the image, and make the image more realistic. Next, select the model image layer, go to the adjustment layer, and take curve adjustment. Press the right button on your mouse, and create a clipping mask. Now change the color channel into the red. Now take the left slider to the right a little bit. It will add some red color to the image. Go closer. Select the curve layer, change the color channel into the green. Take the left slider to the right. Again change the color channel into blue. And again take the left slider to the right. Now you can see the subject match with the background. Next, we will apply dodge and burn to the model to match with the background. Go to the toolbar, and take the dodge tool. Go closer. Now apply the dodge tool near the light, to give the light effect in that area. Take your time and apply the dodge tool. Again apply the dodge tool to the other side of the image. Now we apply the dodge tool. Next, we will apply the burn tool. Go to the toolbar, and take burn tool. Adjust the brush size. Decrease the exposure around 20%. Now apply the burn tool to the model. Now, this is we missed. We didn't remove this area. Now I will remove this area. Go to the toolbar and take the eraser tool, and remove this area. Try as perfect as possible. Now we are done to match the subject with the background. Next, we will add sunshine to the left side. Select the first layer, create a blank layer. Go to the toolbar, and take brush tool. Click to the foreground color. Now change the color. Choose a light orange color. Hit OK. Make the brush size bigger. Be sure the opacity 100%. Now click. Make the brush size smaller. And again click to the middle. Take the move tool. Change the blending mode into the screen. Take the sunlight to the left. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open the free transform option. Zoom out. Now make the sunlight size bigger. And adjust the sunlight as you want. Hit OK. Zoom in. Now decrease the fill. Now that's done. Next, we will give the final color grade with camera or filter. So first, press Shift plus Ctrl plus Alt plus E to merge all the layer into a new layer. If you are using Mac, you need to press Shift plus Command plus Option plus E to merge all the layer into a new layer. It will collect all the sample from the down layers and create a new layer. Press Ctrl or Command plus J to copy the layer. It's for backup, you can use that backup again. Press the right button on your mouse, and convert the layer into a smart object. If you make the layer into a smart object, you can apply any filter, and also you can adjust the filter again in letter. Now go to filter, and camera or filter. Go to HSL adjustment, and make some adjustment for the color. Now go back to the basic color adjustment. Increase the contrast a little bit. Decrease the highlight. Increase the shadows. Adjust the black and white. Go to curve adjustment. Increase the highlight a little bit. Go to details adjustment. Go closer to the image. Now increase the amount. Then increase the luminance. Decrease the luminance details. It will give a smoothy look to the model skin. Now make all the adjustment to get the perfect sharpening and smoothy look on the model face. Now go to the FX adjustment. We will add a vignette to the image. Now I have a trick to give the vignette. First decrease the amount minus 100, then feather 0. Now you can adjust the vignette, and see where you like to give the vignette. Adjust the vignette midpoint, and roundness. Now increase the feather into 100, then adjust the vignette amount. That's done. Now if you like to download the preset of this color adjustment, you can check the link in the description. Hit OK. Now you can see we are done. We just change the background and match the subject with the background. I think we manipulation this image perfectly. So let's see our final output. Now, I just show you all the step, tricks and tips to create that image manipulation in Photoshop. I show you some very good methods that you can use for your own project to manipulate your own image. Thank you so much for watching the tutorial carefully until the end. I hope you like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, you can also check out my other tutorials on my channel. I hope you will also like. Don't forget to tell me what do you think about my channel and my tutorial in the comment section below. Leave a like on this video, and subscribe if you didn't yet. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon. Because if you subscribe and didn't press the bell icon, you will not get any notification of my new tutorials, and it will not help you to learn new things about Photoshop. So be sure to subscribe and also press the bell icon, and don't miss any chance to learn new tricks and tips about Photoshop. So that's it for today. See you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.